Something is circling above Europe, and it doesn't blink, it doesn't land, and it doesn't obey. While Ukraine fights to survive in the mud, the cold, and the fire, and while NATO pours billions into weapons, tanks, and promises, Russia is playing a different game, one that doesn't end with tanks at borders, but with systems that make borders irrelevant. Some weapons are launched, others are unseen, unheard, and still watching. From the shattered villages outside Kharkiv to the airspace NATO calls secure, new names are being whispered, names that were once classified. Burevestnik, a missile that doesn't need fuel, a missile that doesn't need to land, one that can fly for days or weeks, waiting for the moment your guard drops. Oreshnik, an AI so advanced it doesn't wait for orders. It chooses the kill, and it might already be doing so without the world even knowing. These aren't Cold War relics. They are not threats from the future. They are active, real, and possibly already here. So ask yourself, what if NATO's radars aren't looking in the right direction? What if Ukraine isn't the only battlefield? And what if the deadliest Russian weapons haven't even struck yet? Because this is no longer about soldiers or sanctions or strategy. This is about weapons that think, weapons that wait, and a war that could end before the world understands it even began. It began with a treaty shattered. In 2002, the U.S. walked away from the Anti-Ballistic Missile Treaty. Russia saw that as a countdown, so they went underground. And what emerged is Avangard. This isn't a missile, it's a demon that surfs the atmosphere. Riding atop an ICBM, Avangard detaches in space, then dives, maneuvering unpredictably at Mach 27. That's 33,000 kilometers per hour. So fast it outpaces your brain. So agile, no interceptor can track it. Status? Tested, 2018. Declared operational, 2019. Deployed? Yes, right now, aboard SS-19S. Western defenses like THAAD, Aegis, Patriot, useless. You don't just fail to stop Avangard, you fail to realize you were ever under attack. Where Avangard is a scalpel, Sarmat is an extinction-level hammer. Nicknamed Satan II, this super-heavy ICBM wasn't built to strike targets, it was built to wipe them from history. With up to 15 warheads, or glide vehicles like Avangard, Sarmat doesn't care about flight paths. It can go over the North Pole, the South Pole, under your radar, over your cities. One launch, one missile, one country, gone. Status? First test, 2022. Production, 2023. Deployment? Coming in waves from Siberia. This missile doesn't fight wars, it ends them. While the world debates future wars, Russia already fired the first shot. Its name? Kinzhal, the Dagger. Born from the bones of the Iskander, Kinzhal is launched from MiG-31Ks and screams through the sky at Mach 10 to 12. It doesn't cruise, it plunges with brute hypersonic force. Since 2022, it's been used in Ukraine. It's hit bunkers, power grids, air defense systems. NATO can barely react, let alone stop it. Kinzhal is the nightmare that already left the launch rail. This isn't a prototype, it's a weapon of today, and it's already killing. Some missiles race, this one waits. Burevestnik, the Storm Petrel, is a cruise missile without a finish line. It runs on a miniature nuclear reactor. It can fly indefinitely, low, quiet, slow, but eternal. It doesn't need speed. It only needs time. Tested between 2017 and 2020. One attempt in 2019 ended in radioactive tragedy. Scientists dead, silence imposed. But Russia kept going. The status? Experimental. But if they perfect it, Burevestnik could circle the planet and strike when no one's watching. It doesn't race to target, it waits until you forget to look. Most missiles follow orders. This one writes its own. In 2023, a new codename surfaced, Oreshnik. Not a missile, but a mind. An artificial brain embedded in cruise systems like KH-101 and Iskander variants. It sees terrain. It hears comms. It reads the battlefield in real time. And then it decides. Oreshnik was reportedly field-tested in Ukraine in 2024 to 2025. It found mobile command centers, electronic warfare hubs, targets we thought were safe. Western AI systems still ask permission. Oreshnik? It just acts. This isn't software, it's war, coded into silicon, and it doesn't blink. Five weapons, some already launched, others waiting. Avangard tears the air faster than thought. Sarmat silences cities in one roar. Kinzhal drives steel through bunkers that once felt invincible. Burevestnik haunts the sky with no destination. And Oreshnik, it doesn't wait for war. It makes war. For Ukraine, these systems rewrite the rules of survival. For NATO, they raise a final fatal question. What if nothing we've built can stop what's already coming?